Morning students, today we will discuss about food. Where does it come from? As we know, all living organisms, plants, animals like cow, dog, we human beings, trees and even microorganisms all need food. Why do we need food? The first question is, why do we need food? How would you feel without food? Why do people die of hunger? The basic answers of all these questions is food, because without food we cannot survive. As answer to all these questions is food, because food is the source of energy and is required by all living organisms to survive. Now the function of food is, we need food to grow, develop and repair our body. Secondly, food gives our body energy and nutrients that we need in order to grow more, work, play, think and learn. Now the question is, where does this food come from? We all living organisms get their food by either plants or animals. So the major source of food are the plants and animals. Different organisms derive their nutrition in the form of plants or in the form of animals. On basis of these nutritions, all the organisms are divided into two categories. First is autotrophs and second is heterotrophs. Here the word autotrophs. Auto means self and trophs means nutrition. So autotrophs are basically producers. These are the living things that can prepare their own food. So these are known as producers. Examples of producers are trees, shrubs and herbs. Now second is heterotrophs. These are the nutritions, or these are the organisms which depend on other animals for their nutritions. Heterotrophs are classified into three categories. First one is consumers, second ones are decomposers or saprophytes, and third one is parasites. Now the first is consumers. So these other living things derive or obtain their nutrition from other organisms. These are known as consumers. Consumers basically depend on producers. So these are sheep and tiger. Second one is decomposers. These are the living things that derive nutrients from dead and decayed matter. These are known as decomposers or saprophytes. Example of decomposers are mushroom and moss. Now the third type of heterotrophs are parasites. So these are the plants or animals live on or inside living organisms in order to get food, and they also cause harm to their host. Example of parasites are deer tick and roundworm. Here the word host means, as roundworms can live in humans or animals body. So that body is host to roundworms and they also cause harm to human beings as well as animals. Now we discuss about producer in detail, how they prepare their own food. So basically plants prepare their own food. Plants make food with carbon dioxide from air and water from soil in the presence of chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green pigment present in the leaves. Using solar energy. Solar energy is the energy from sunlight.
By carbon dioxide, water and solar energy is known as, this process is known as photosynthesis, and oxygen is a byproduct, means it releases with the
second one is consumers. Consumers are also known as heterotrophs. So animals that cannot prepare their own food, they depend on other plants or animals for their food. They are also known as consumers. There are three types of consumers. First one is herbivorous, second is carnivorous, and third one is omnivorous. Herbivorous, examples of producers are trees, shrubs, and herbs. So herb is taken from herbivorous is taken from herbs. Now herbivorous, animals that eat only plants are known as herbivorous. Examples are cow and deer. Now carnivorous, animals that eat only animals are known as carnivorous. Example are lion and bear. Now third one is omnivorous. Animals that eat both plants and animals are known as omnivorous. Examples are human beings, crow. Clear? Now we will discuss about herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous in details and their characteristics features. Now first one is herbivorous. Food. Now herbivorous like the white-tailed deer and goat have tall molars with flat upper surfaces for chewing, and some herbivorous like cow store semi-digested food in a part of their stomach and bring it back to the mouth to chew again. To chew again means jugali karna. Now the second type of consumers are carnivorous. As carnivores eat meat and flesh, so they have well-defined canines and incisors. Now canines help in to tear meat and incisors helps to cut meat. So therefore they have well-defined or well-developed canine and incisors. So carnivores have sharp and pointed teeth to tear flesh. Flesh means meat. Their canines and incisors are well-developed. Carnivores need canine to kill and tear meat. Some birds have clawed. Clawed means long curved nails, pointed toes and sharp pointed beaks to grab and stab the flesh of their prey. Grab means hold and stab means to push or plunge the flesh of their prey. Prey means shikari. As tiger eat goat, so goat is a prey to tiger. Now third one is omnivorous. As we know, omnivorous eat both plants and animals. So they have front teeth known as incisors and molars to eat or to tear and to grind up the food they eat. Now mammals like grizzly bears and human beings and birds like crow and woodpeckers are omnivorous. So these are the example of omnivorous. Here grizzly means gray due to bears gray color. Now omnivorous survive well in many environments because they eat both plants and animals. Here survive means live.
Many omnivorous animals have front teeth. Front teeth are incisors which help them rip into meat. Rip means to tear quickly and bite into fruits and vegetables. As they eat both meat and fruit, so they have front teeth are so their front teeth are well developed. Now molars help them grind up meat and chew their food. Here grind means to cut the food into smaller particles. Now feeding habits of all living things are not same, as herbivorous eat plants and carnivorous eat meat, and omnivorous eat both plant and animals. So different animals show characteristics which help them derive energy from food they eat. Now you have to complete this activity. Here animals name are given and you have to write the name of food they eat. Now last question is given there. Are the food habits of all living things the same? Kya sabhi jo living things hote hain un sabhi ki food habits same hoti hai? So you have to write the answer of this question on the basis of what you have learnt above.